Our goal with fetal surgery repair for spina bifida is to get the mother to 37 weeks.
Babies who undergo fetal surgery tend to be born prematurely, and in the MOMS trial, they were born at an average gestational age just beyond 34 weeks, but 10% were born at 30 weeks or prior to that time, which is quite premature.
Over 65% of them get past that 35-week mark. And then it becomes a matter of timing of delivery.
We've made an incision in the uterus that is not in a safe part of the uterus to allow the woman to labor in any pregnancy going forward.
So the baby is delivered via cesarean section in the special delivery unit.
The special delivery unit was built for the mother carrying a baby with a birth defect, was built for the mother carrying a baby with spina bifida.
We as the resuscitation team feel like we are very prepared for those deliveries. We have excellent communication with the obstetricians, and we have access to all their prenatal imaging. We know those babies very well, and we coordinate their delivery and their care.
Dr. Johnson delivered Sean.
He came out very healthy. 6 pounds, 7 ounces.
Which was a very good size for a child that's born at 36 and a half weeks. Mm-hmm. He was a big boy.
We always make a point of bringing the baby to the mother prior to bringing the baby down to the NICU so that the mother and father and any relatives that they want can see the baby.
And from there, we take the baby straight down to the newborn infant ICU, and the moms are close. You know, they can come down as soon as they're feeling well, and if there's something going on, we're able to go straight back up to their unit.
The idea of being together is huge when you're talking about what's already a very stressful situation.
So really, the SDU has been a wonderful thing.